your town health retreat and a long time Vinyasa flow yoga instructor and teacher trainer. And this class is, I call it the up your game class. This is going to be a sequence, about 30, 35 minute sequence, to just little ways that you can kind of up your yoga practice this year. So it's meant to be released on sort of a New Year's Day. It's like a New Year, New You kind of thing. A lot of people, you know, the New Year, we make resolutions. This is the year I'm going to take up yoga. Or this is the year, you know, my yoga practice, I'm going to do this or do that or make it, you know, stronger or sort of more challenging, whatever it might be. And I filmed a sort of beginner class for people who are just wanting to start yoga this year and kind of dip their toe into it and see what it's like. But this is my sort of, you know, the other spectrum. There's people who practice yoga, like a lot of obviously students and people I work with, and they want to kind of up their game, you know, so maybe this is the year to kind of up your game. So it's definitely a level 2-3 challenging practice. I'm going to just kind of go through a myriad of things. Some things might be relatively actually not challenging for you, but I'm going to add kind of other layers and ways that you can kind of take poses and start working them a little bit deeper, you know, or maybe just working in transition or just kind of, yeah, up in your game. So let's get right into it because it's just, you know, it's not the longest class ever, but I'm just trying to give you little tips, little tricks, little things we can do to have a good kind of practice together or fun. Maybe you're watching this on New Year's Day, maybe you're watching this in the middle of summer, different time of year, it doesn't really matter. But, you know, it's a way to kind of just practice opening up to something maybe a little bit different. So bring your palms into prayer. We'll start like perhaps, you know, a lot of our classic poses here. So just nice Tadasana. Big breath in and a nice exhale breath. Okay. And we're going to take a little mudra and gesture. So again, maybe you don't use mudras or gestures in your practice. Maybe this is the year you want to start introducing a few. One that I like to do is an Uttara Bodhi mudra. So take your hands apart, like that, it's the easiest way to show you. Keep your index finger and thumb together and just kind of interlace the other fingers. So it looks kind of like that, yeah? Bring it in close to your chest. That's sort of the sense of that enlightened self, sort of right in the center. And just take a few breaths here with this gesture. So just kind of starting rolling the shoulders down. This kind of gets you in that nice space of, you know, a reminder of also standing quite nice and tall and breathing in and breathing out. And we're ideally trying to find almost like a count of four with those breaths. So breathing in, out, 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 out. Okay, so it's not rushed. Even though something's challenging or even dynamic or fluid, doesn't mean it's necessarily fast and rushed, okay? Or fast and furious flow. It's up your game flow, okay? Nice, one more breath. Nice big breath in. And a nice ha, exhale breath. Let your mudra kind of come away from itself, reaching out to the sky. Exhale, releasing all the way down in a nice sort of forward fold. Okay, so inhale, lengthening, looking up halfway. Let's start getting into jumping back, into chaturanga. Okay, so right away, we're going to get right into pretty strong opening movement, pressing it back into downward facing dog. Breathing in. So if you're jumping back, you're always jumping back in chaturanga, you don't jump back in plank. You need to have some sort of malleability, some softness in the elbows. So just a little bit of a, you know, word to the wise there. Maybe just let's, you know, just kind of work out a little bit through down dog for a moment, pressing through the ankles, pressing through the heels, you know, just kind of stretching out, bicycling your feet a little bit, your legs a little bit, boom, flutter your lips a little bit, you know, softening your knees. It might look like I'm hyperextending, by the way, but I'm not. This arm was broken when I was a kid, and it was put back in backwards. So it looks kind of funny. So it's not that I'm hyperextending. It's just kind of a backwards, weird little arm. So we all have our flaws. And luckily, it hasn't stopped me from doing much. So anyway, just in case you're seeing that. But do soften your elbows a little if you hyperextend. That's certainly easy enough to do. Nice big breath up. Just keep your hips straight for a moment. Nice big breath up. Breathing in there. We're going to coil. We're going to slip it kind of across and through. Okay. We're just going to inhale, rise up. Exhale, release down. Sweep your right leg up behind you, nice and straight. Bring it forward just next to your right hand. Your Virabhadrasana 1, rising up. Give yourself a big hug, surrendered warrior, bowing forward. Inhale, reaching up to the sky, opening it up. Exhale, bring your fingertips down, come off your back left heel. Instead of stepping back, add a little split onto this one. Nice big breath up. Bend to the right knee, a little soft, and exhale, low lunge. Inhale, up high lunge. Exhale, releasing, come through your plank. Chaturanga, Obviously, knees, chest, chin is an option too, right? I'm just, like I said, it's just an up your game, so we're just kind of taking slightly stronger variations. Happy for you to modify just like any other practice. Inhale, left leg up. Knee comes in, it starts to go across, pretty far up, and then straighten it out. Drop your right heel, nice big stretch, just opening up. Exhale, release your right hand down. Squeeze that leg, bring it back up. Left foot comes in, just next to your left hand, right hand drop, right heel drops. Lift up, inhale. Surrender warrior, left side, give yourself a nice hug, surrender down. Inhale, 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 rise up. Exhale, fingertips towards the floor. Come off the back right heel, reach up, nice and nice big split for a moment, tuck your head in, just feel that nice stretch. Soften your left knee, exhale, bring it down. Inhale, rise up to the sky, opening it up. Exhale, releasing. Take it back in through plank, and again, little chaturanga, mindful of your elbows, mindful of your necks, and taking it back into downward facing dog. Breathing here for one, exhaling. Breathing here for two. Excuse me, exhale. Breathing in for three. Exhaling. Breathing in for four. Exhale. We're actually going to drop our knees to the floor on this for a second. Inhale, rise. Not so much for a break, but actually open the back. Do a couple back bends. Inhale, reach up. So we're just getting the back primed for those back bends that we're going to drop into just a half camel. Exhale, releasing. Please bring your elbows down, interlace your fingers, pop back as if you're doing a down dog. Come to your dolphin for a moment. Breathing here for one. Exhaling, perhaps again bicycling your feet, your legs a little bit. For two, and just kind of pressing through, just like you would your down dog, that dolphin shape. So you keep kind of opening up through the chest. One more breath. Now look up at your hands. Take your hands out. Try to simultaneously push your elbows off the floor at the same time. And stretch out in your downward facing dog. Looking forward, we're going to come forward into the jump, but I want you to just try, again, it's an up your game. Try to bring your hips more over your hands, so you come more forward, rather than just a little kind of jump, okay? So let's do that again. Come to your downward dog. Try and bring your hips over your hands. Land one more in between. Exhale, bow. Just try a few times, buddy. Inhale, rise. Open it up. Take it back. We're going to clasp our hands on the way down on this one. Breathing, squeeze it in nice and deep. We're going to bend through our knees, a little chair, Utkatasana. Little twist to the right side, just twisting it out for a moment. Inhale to center, still with knees bent. Go ahead, twist. Exhale to the other. Inhale, coming to center. Exhale, forward bend, squeeze it up. Inhale, lengthening, working up halfway again. You're jumping to chaturanga, not to plank, so that means the elbows need to bend. And you're not jumping, you know, like you're tapping the floor, right? Exhale, release here. Right leg goes up to the sky. This is the instruction. We're going to bring our right knee to our chest. We're going to take our right leg back up and do a little jump switch. You're going to reach your right leg high and your right leg is going to land and your left foot is going to come forward. Warrior one. So do that a couple times. Surrender your warrior again. Bow. Inhale, reach it up to the sky. Exhale, release hands. Don't worry about the plank. Come off your back heel. Put your left leg up high, please. Bring your left knee into your nose. Take your left leg up high. Again, you bend, in this case, your right knee. It's a jump switch. It's almost like you're going to do a handstand, but you switch it out. Step your right foot forward. So it's almost like you're teasing a handstand, but you actually just switch your legs. So don't overthink it. This is actually not a whole lot going on in terms of complicating. It's just kind of trying to get up quite nice and high. We're going to come to plank now. Okay? Again, check the neck. Inhale, open, open, open. Exhale, coil it back. Breathing here for one. Exhaling. Breathing here for two. Exhale. You're going to add a little something on this one. You're going to take your left hand just above your sort of right elbow. Breathe here for three. You're adding some of the three-limbed dog. One more breath. We're going to take our right foot and we step it. Without putting the left hand, drop it. You're gonna open it up to warrior two now. That left arm drags back. Open your right palm, reach behind, you get a nice big stretch. Exhale, bring your hands almost like they're gonna come down to the inside, but draw them in prayer and come to that sort of rainbow, Skandasa warrior. So you open it up. And take your right toes in and press it up to tree pose. Breathing up, inhale. Exhale, release your right arm underneath left. Curl your right knee forward, bend your left knee, and bring it into eagle, breathing in for one. Exhaling. Breathing in for two. Exhale. Breathe it in for three. Now, we're going to reach up, or you're going to come up. You're going to reach up, and you're going to try and step back up. Like you're doing a warrior two, that you're going to step, you're going to pick it up into half moon. Just having a little fun creative flow here. Lift that left arm, perhaps. Maybe grab onto that left ankle. And again, perhaps work on upping your game by bringing your right hand, your right hand on your right ankle. Breathing that here. Hard to talk in demo. Come all the way back to the warrior two, please, your warrior two. Windmill your arms down. Keep your right leg up. Reaching your leg up, flipping around to your wild thing. Opening it up. This time, take your right arm, as well as that left elbow. Kind of pimping your wild thing a bit. Trying to pick up those toes. So just breathe here. Have a little play. Maybe work your knee up a little bit. One more breath. And then flip back around. Three-legged plank this time. So that's a pretty strong movement. Just, again, it's upping your game and your wild thing. Lifting it up, breathe up. Exhale, step your right foot forward, low lunge. We're gonna go back to that split, bringing it up. Now bring your hands on to your ankle, your right ankle. Breathing there. So just upping a little bit our stem split now with a supine balance. One more breath. Good, releasing. Kick it up to high lunge. Breathe it up. Exhale, release. Just go back to downward dog. Breathing here for one. Exhaling. Breathing here for two. Catch your breath. Exhale. Breathing in for three. Drop your knees to the floor. Reach up to the sky. Please, again, we're going to drop back in camel, but this time, let's go a little deeper. If you feel warm enough, drop those ankles. Reach up. If you're feeling warm or you just have that kind of back and you're okay to drop into full camel, go ahead. Start exploring bigger back bends now. Up to you, right? Bring yourself back up. Again, back into that puppy pose. Stretch it out. Reach it out. Take a breath here. And a nice big exhale. Elbows back onto the floor. Again, interlace or even palms press, whatever you'd like. Just come into that dolphin again, stretching it out. Breathing in. Breathing it out. Pressing up. Looking up at your hands. Again, open up your forearms. Try and press simultaneously your elbows up. Walk your hands a little in if you need to and press it out. Okay? Take a breath. A nice exhale breath. Just try. Take a few breaths just in normal Adho Mukha, downward facing dog. Then take your right hand, please, just above that left elbow and kind of balance. Looks like a little bit like a number four here. So you're grabbing above, just above the elbow. Tendency is to want to lean to the side, try not to. Keep pressing the right heel down. Go ahead and try and step your left foot forward, except left hand. Drop your right heel, windmill up to your warrior two. Okay? We're going to sink in nice and deep here. We're going to reach up behind, and as if you're bringing your hands down the inside, you're going to bring your hands to prayer and sink now the other way, in that sort of rainbow. You drop your toes in, by the way. Forgive my backside, but I'm going to push up into that tree. Try and push up into the tree without kind of pulling your foot in. So again, up in your game in your tree pose. Instead of taking your foot and placing it, it's good to just try and work a little bit. How far can I bring it up without my hands, right? Right? Reaching up to the sky. Okay, left arm underneath right, which is the opposite, like an eagle. Take your left knee forward, bend that right leg, squeeze it in, and just breathe here for a few moments in that eagle pose. Breathing in, breathing out, breathing in, breathing out. One more breath. We're gonna pop off. We're gonna step into that half moon. So take a pretty big step, lift up through your hands, your arm, right arm. Then through our chandrachapasana, so find that nice sense of kind of opening. Maybe have a play. You can even take it to your right ankle, by the way. I kind of showed you that on the other side, but maybe you pimp your up your game in your half moon. Let go all the way, take it back, and take it nice and deep. Windmill your arms down. Let's kick up through that left leg. Take it up nice and big. You're gonna bend it and you're gonna go the other side. So we're gonna reach around and just kind of open it up. Again, just upping our game in a wild thing. Grabbing just above the right elbow and kind of picking up the toes. Maybe even picking up the leg a little. You know, just kind of that wild thing making it a little more wild. Take your left hand down. Step your left foot forward. High lunge. Open it up. Let's go for that split other side. So we're going to reach our right toes. Upping it here a little bit, our game, by trying to bring our hands on our ankles. So let's just breathe it in here. Take another breath. Releasing right foot down, inhale, rise up. Three-legged plank on this side. So left foot, in fact, I think I should have done one in between, but that's okay. Three-legged plank, we'll do it now. And kick your left leg up, 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 nice and high. Step your left foot forward, low lunge. Step your right foot forward. Exhale, bow. Inhale, reach up to the sky, open it up, breathe it up, and take it all the way down. Exhale, release. Inhale, lengthen halfway, float back, reach up, open it up, and take it back into downward facing dog. Now just catch a few breaths here, okay? We're going to try again to jump forward with our hips over our hands, and this time we'll do it kind of five times. In other words, we're going to bend our knees, and we're gonna kind of pop up. Okay, first five times like that. If you get up there, we'd love for you to try to practice your handstand a few times. But more importantly is bending and trying to get your hips up high over your hands. Okay, breathing here. If you get your handstand, again, we're gonna up our game. We're gonna start working down, dropping through the forward fold with the ankle, with the toes giving a little tap to the wrist, pushing back. So strong movement, but that's how we're going to up our game now this year. So breathing in, breathing out. If that didn't work, obviously you could just drop your feet and jump back to your transition, okay? So obviously I'm just showing you things to kind of start working this year a little bit. Maybe if you feel like bringing some little more challenge to some of this traditional stuff. We're going to reach up to the sky, so we'll give our arms, legs, everything else a little break. Don't just say it'd be easy. Lift up. So another nice kind of counter pose, opening up, especially if you tried the dropping from the handstand, plugging down. So take a nice breath in, and a nice exhale. Coming forward, come to puppy pose again. Sending those arms out, reaching here. Breathing in, and breathing out. Nice exhale. Okay, we're gonna give ourselves a little break for a moment. We're gonna slide forward. I'd love for you to go ahead and catch your hands behind. Lift up just to open up again through the back. So we're gonna take a couple breaths here. Start to bend your ankles towards you, catch your ankles. Push through your legs, not your neck. Push your legs up, your neck will just follow. Get a nice big stretch. Let yourself go, let your head relax for a moment. Take a big exhale breath. Let's do that a second time, grab from the inside. Take a breath in, open it up. Stretch out through those shoulders, through your back. Breathing here. Another big breath. Exhale, release your head again. Forehead down, breath in. A nice breath out. Let's bring our hands into prayer, or into prayer, underneath. Tuck our toes, lift your thighs and knees, kind of push yourself up to plank now, instead of using your back, just trying to start working through that transition. Come back in through Adho Mukha Svanasana, downward facing dog, breathing in. Breathing out. Okay, right foot forward. Let's open up Warrior One just for a breath. We're going to clasp our hands behind. We're going to roll those shoulders pretty deep now. Try and get your head, you know, start working your head a little deeper in. You've been doing this a while. Come back up. Let's draw down onto our left knee for a moment. Top of back foot down. Take your left fingertips. Open up sideways. Just kind of give yourself a nice stretch. Come back up through center. Inhale, rise. Take your hands in prayer. So we'll take our left elbow just over. This is a very Presley sequence, by the way, so you might have to modify if you find it too Presley. But like I said, just for the spirit of this practice, it's meant to be sort of upping our game. So I'm going to show you a pretty you know, kind of challenging variations. And you modify. So first things first, lifting up. It's a half revolve, half moon. But obviously we're gonna up our game using the bind. Stage one. Left foot drops in line with your right foot. Stage two, instead of a standing twist where you grab your foot, keep the bind and start to look over. It's the exact same thing you would do, but you know, now you have the bind. So again, the next stage and some of the stuff. So you all know eagle, or you should know eagle, I'm sure you do. Adding again, upping our game by adding the double eagle. So you still have the bind. Super press the area. Oh, one more breath. Fun though. Come on up. Unpretzel yourself from all that. Step back. When you'll next, shake out that left leg. Open that up pretty big. Flip your dog again. And this time, if you can flip into more of a back bend, one left leg still stays bent, right leg stretches up. So a deeper wild thing, maybe into a variation of a wheel with legs like this. Up to you, obviously, you don't have to. Flip back around, three-legged plank. Lift that left leg up high. Nice exhale, we're gonna bring our left knee to our nose, give a little tap. Step our left foot just in the middle of our hands. Well, in the middle, sorry, of our mats, in between, like the space between our hands. Add a handstand in here, go ahead, practice. Lifting up to the sky, okay? Upping our game, adding in, if you can, trying to work your lotus into your handstand now. Obviously, like I said, challenging, but maybe it's something you played with this year, maybe not. Letting go, right foot steps back in the middle, left foot goes back. Inhale, exhale back down to where you were. Okay, we're gonna take our right knee a bit more forward, just kind of opening up a bit here. Just feel free to put some padding. We're gonna take our left knee, our left foot, sorry. So we're gonna be on our left knee and just kind of squeeze in, opening the quad now, because we're gonna play with something in a moment that you kind of, it's a deep back bend, so you need quads, and quads to be open. So just squeeze it in again, fold something under your right knee, and just, you know, maybe open up, get a nice little stretch there. Maybe grab and come through. A little bit of mermaid, just breathing here. Exhaling, release. Top toes shift back into downward facing dog. Breathing in. And a nice ha. Exhale out. Left foot forward. Drop your right knee. Let's do the press the bit first, right? So right fingertips go down. Here's a big stretch. Come back through center. Inhale, rise. Exhale, right elbow over. Get a nice twist there. Nice little twist. Okay. So, options. Lift that knee. Reach up. Let's go for the bind. Okay, so keep your bind through this transition. Even though it's tricky, keep it. Shift forward, just like you would a revolved half moon, but you try and keep the bind. Keep trying to straighten the best you can through your legs. Keep breathing. Keep breathing, especially if you're talking. Keep breathing, lift it up. Let's bring our right foot in. We're gonna lift up. Just like your classic twist, but adding this little tricky bit, right? Double eagle, so it's pretzly, pretzly, pretzly stuff. Do your best. Just like your classic eagle, but obviously you have this twist now. Makes it trickier. Come on up. Whoa, unwind all that. Shake it up. Right leg. A good old back bend will counter that nicely, all that pretzly bit. Open up from all that stuff. And again, if you can take a twist into flip over into a back bend. Again, time to maybe up the game of moving your wild thing into more of a wheel. Flip back around, come around, three-legged plank perhaps. Stepping our right foot in the middle. Having another play with another handstand, just popping up, maybe a few times by the way, it might be just like this. Okay, don't feel like, you know, you're upping your game, might be just trying to get into handstand. If you have your handstand, try again, second time. Just try. Try to bring those heels, sorry, the toes to the wrists. Shooting back to chaturanga. Pressing back. Oh, downward dog. Step your left foot just a little bit forward. Drop your right knee. Not an easy one, but it's a good one to maybe have on your list this year. Just to know it's there. Squeeze in, let's open up the quad on the other side. Take a nice couple breaths. Stay with a nice stretch, stay a bit more upright, and then perhaps bring it in. Again, you might want to wrap and open up the chest a bit. Exhale, release. Switching it out, go ahead, shake that. And just come to a nice downward facing dog. Catch your breath, breathing in, and a nice ha, breathing out. Flutter your lips. Good, come forward to plank. Slowly lower. We're almost, a few more things to go. I just want to show you some other ways that are really kind of fun to kind of, you know, switch things up a little bit, rather than always doing similar things. So let's bend our legs again. We're going to revisit Dhanurasana and revisit bow. Lift up. Now catch more your ankles, not the tops of your feet, your ankles on this. And we're going to reach up to the sky. Okay, and you are going to roll off your mat, so make sure you're happy with the floor and it's on the side of your mat. Let's go ahead and roll to the left to start. And you're going to roll all the way now and push it up into a quite a locked bridge. So we're going to be catching your ankles, lifting it up. Breathing here for a moment. Now keep your sit bones working forward. Don't lift them up. It's different than shoulder stand. You're gonna take your hands underneath like a little tray and you're just gonna pitch your legs up. So it's different than a shoulder stand. But see, there's this hollow back. It's basically prepping me because maybe we're gonna practice hollow. So just try to get kind of a hollow back where you're pressing your hips, your head's tucked under, and then release it down. Bring yourself back in. And try not to bring your knees together. Try to keep the shape as you flip back up. Okay, other side. Flip other way. Try to flip through. Lifting up again. Okay, lifting up, 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 up. Just opening up again. Bring a little kind of tray under your back. So you're supporting, so it's a little different. The hands and my fingers are working up in the direction of my back. Again, I'm keeping this hollow back. I'm pressing my chest. And I'm kind of trying to lift my legs. But it's different than shoulder stand. You know that. If you're practicing this class, I know you're familiar with the difference here. Even if you've never done this variation. Lifting up, open up. Again, drop, 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 and lift it up. Exhale, release. I think catch a break. Bowing here for a moment. Breathing in. Breathing out. Hands under, top toes, push up to plank. Keep going. A little bit more to go. I know it's a strong flow, but it's just meant to be, you know, these little examples of ways that you can keep up in your game, you know, and just kind of making things fun, keep things inspiring. Right foot forward. Okay, warrior two. So let's play with this again. We're going to go down to that rainbow warrior. We're going to go down inside with eagle arms this time. We're going to slide it down. We'll tuck our toes and we're gonna try to push it up into that tree again. So that motion again, you know, trying to not use your hands. We're gonna come to eagle again. This time, we're gonna keep our legs, we're gonna unravel and take, once again, we're kind of as a bit Presley. Your left elbow over, find your hands, just coming into prayer. So it's kind of like a much kinder double Presley. But the reason is, we wanna take our hands down. You have to release your right foot a little bit from the lock. There's no way around that. You're trying to come into essentially eagle. What looks like a Vinyasa or a side crow, and then wrap your legs to an eagle. So I'm gonna show you just from this side, so you can see it. Stay with it, practice it again. So you bring your legs out and you wrap those toes. So again, just upping your game from the classic Vinyasa to that eagle. And then coming back in, spiral back around to where you were. Bring that foot up, push through. Come back into that tree. Step out far. And wide and open it up. Nice and big. Just stretching it out. Again, I catch the foot just to kind of open. And we're gonna take it back down into warrior two. I'm gonna slide it in. Take your right foot in. We're gonna just, we'll do the other side in a second. We're gonna add a little something. Breathing up. Exhale, sliding down. Catch your ankles, go ahead. Bow your head in for a moment. Your head might be on the floor, that's fine. Take a few breaths. So we're gonna have a play. Again, a lot of times we come into this and, you know, the teacher will say, as teachers, if you're teaching, you know, do tripod. It's nice to
up your game sometimes, you can come to your head. But instead of bringing your hands into tripod, take them wide. It's a bit of a funky one. Take them almost in line with your toes. There are my toes. I just kind of have sort of the students kind of feel their toes. Take your fingertips about the distance of your toes and try from there just to kind of bring your legs up using this kind of funky hand. You're on spider fingers, right? It might look inconspicuous, but it's pretty tricky. The spider fingers slowly come down, especially when you start talking. But anyway, you get the point. So trying to practice now these kind of precarious handstands, or headstands, really fun to do. So slowly roll it on up. Take your left foot out, okay? So we're just doing it a little differently. Wrap right arm underneath left, slide it down. So again, it's a pretty challenging sequence, but you know, especially if you're doing level two classes or teaching level two, fun to have these things that even if you don't get anywhere close to them, just to know that they are kind of having fun. So we come up, let's wrap it in double eagle, or in eagle, sorry. Reaching in, Garudasana. Unravel just the arms, slide that right elbow a little bit down. You will have to unlock more than likely the feet just to get them out, but try to slip them up and around. On that one, you have to unlock them, but kind of depending on your hips. So you're slipping around with your legs into a double, or sorry, an eagle arm balance, eagle legs. Come back in to center, unlock there, and push, push, push. You're trying to push up with just the one foot if you can. Again, just to up your game in terms of the transitions. Go wide, step up wide, reach up. Try and step still with an alignment even though you're flowing. Another kind of, you know, challenge upping our game can be even as simple as just trying to find alignment with the flow. Sometimes it's a challenge. Sometimes when we're flowing, we don't really give much mind to alignment. So dropping right into, you know, your alignment, reaching up. Let's go ahead. On this one, we'll just wiggle it down, shake it on out. We're kind of facing the other side now. Take your left foot back out, warrior two. And let's come once more in the center, okay? Nice big breath in. And just press Rita Padottanasana for one. So pigeon toeing your feet, the C version. Clasp those hands. Just do again, give your shoulders a little break from that arm balance. Breathing in. Breathing out. Breathing in. Breathing out. Soften your knees a little. Roll on up, please. Again, we can up our game here. We're going to lift it up, especially if you've not tried this before. Instead of doing tripod, you're always doing tripod, why not challenge yourself the next time you're here? Rather than doing tripod, try to work up into a straddle handstand. So, same kind of thing in terms of inversion, but you're just trying to lift up now through the legs, keeping your straddle. Breathing in, breathing out for one. Breathing in, breathing out for two. Keep breathing, that's most important. You're gonna slowly lower, try to sort of slowly lower to your straddle. Whoa, and come back up. So again, you know, maybe if you're always doing tripod and it's easy, try something different. Up your game, press back. Let's come forward, come through, open it up. And reach, open with your knees, come to wisdom pose. And breathe here, okay. You may want to take your hands, you may want to walk them out and just your elbows and just stretch your shoulders. Almost finished. Okay, so final couple of things in our up your game. Up your game 2016 flow here. Alright, so remember we did that little funny version of looks like a shoulder stamp, there was a hollow back in there. We're gonna put that to use, okay? So I'm assuming if you're practicing 2-3, pretty hard flow, you probably have a good grip on your forearm stamp, okay? Forget my assumption, but hopefully you do. I'm working on that assumption that you have forearm stand. If not, you're gonna have to practice your forearm stand a little more. That'll be maybe up in your game, is getting that the forearm stand in play. Sorry, I just fixed my hair out of the way. So in this case, we're just gonna have a play with a bit of a hollow back forearm stand. Adding in, quite a big back bend in this. We're gonna add in some legs. We're gonna have a little play. I'm just gonna show you, and you can try it a few times. So in our forearm stand, we're gonna come out with forearms. Now we're gonna up our game by turning our palms into un. challenge the length of breath, okay? Same distance though in terms of you would use for your forearm stance. So you might want to measure it out. One way I have my students always measure it out is if you're comfortable here in this version of child's pose with your hips elevated, you're more than comfortable probably here. You know, this is probably your own body's alignment, certainly your shoulders, okay? So palms in like what's like a prayer. Just like you would your forearm stance, tuck your toes. Stay looking forward for a moment. Whichever leg you want to kick with, up to you, work it up. Now, take a split. As you start splitting, start bringing your head in. And the trick is, keep pushing your elbows on the floor so you lift your chest. Start to bend your leg, the one that's out, and we're gonna really try and bring our chest forward and really try and drop those toes as close as you can towards your fingertips and hold it without dropping. So you're trying to kind of suspend yourself without dropping. Keep breathing, hold it there. You might have to watch and try and pause. Okay, keep bringing yourself through with your shoulders as much as you can in your chest. And then those toes may or may come out. Take a couple breaths. We'll do the other side. Just hold there a moment. So we're just trying to pull our head through and hold it without dropping and keep the legs kind of split. As you saw, I'm kind of coming into quite a big sort of back bend. Trying to open up. So other side, take yourself up. In this case, my right leg will go out, whichever one you didn't do. Start tucking the toes in. Don't forget the bottom does. Everything else is still there, right? Keep pushing through your chest. Opening up. Keep popping your chest through. One more breath. Maybe those toes get close to the floor. And then take yourself up and out. Oh, and breathe. Exhaling. So obviously, the upper game quotient of that one was to bring your head through and take quite a deep back bend, but without bringing your foot all the way down. So it's like you're suspended. Really, obviously, big shoulders need to be open for this, like to warmed up for this. So really pushing your chest through, bringing your head through, and then obviously that back bend that's just, it's still control, so using your flexibility, but you still have to keep your strength so that your toe doesn't just drop and you go flipping out into a back bend, unless that's what you want to do. Obviously, we can do a million transitions from there. We can take our toes, really fun. Maybe next class I film, we'll practice taking our toes, dropping them into our hands, working extreme back flexibility. For that, I'm sure that's plenty to up your game from your forearm stand, start dropping into a bit of a hollow back split, or even just trying to take your head through, that might be stage one for that, okay? Good stuff. Okay, bring your feet, your knees a little more in, not quite glued, just a little more. Catch your hands, countering that a bit with the terms of rounding the spine. Grab it, just rolling it up here. Nice big breath in, and a nice exhale out. Tucking your toes under a little to let your hands, let the backs of your hands come to the floor. Lift your knees off the floor again. Just upping our game from classic Shirshasana to a variation where you have the backs of your hands coming into your headstand again. This time though, with a variation of the hands. So we're just coming into a fun sort of inversion. Breathing here. So you have to just kind of try and practice with your hands out. So just trying to find these little variations that help us just keep working to an inspiring, challenging place, right? Don't make it so hard that you're hurting yourself, but just to challenge you, you know, to up the game. Okay, one more breath. Okay, so we're gonna bring our hands into tripod. So we're gonna have a play, all right? We're going to bring ourselves with our forearms down, okay? And we're gonna just take yourself, if you can, when you split your legs, and you try to push up back to that forearm and flip out to your back bend where you engage those hands again. And you work for a moment to a little deeper breath, a little sense of pressing through those arms. Pretty big enough. Nice big stretch. Dropping your head. Listen to this, or you're going to have to watch. Extending out. Bring your fingertips down. You're kind of doing old school Setubandhasana. Bring your fingers coming down. Oh, so now you're on your back. So a little different way to transition onto the back from handstand. Take a moment here.
Take a little counter pose. And that's very strong, by the way. Satchibandhasana, we usually say, is this bridge, but actually Satchibandhasana is that one I just showed you on the crown of your head. If it's too much, you can take a fish as your variation for that. So flipping from your back bend, moving into your fish from your back bend when your forearm stands, or your student's forearm stands. Bring your knees in, give it a little rounding. Little plow, always nice. Just to stretch all that stuff out. Breathing here. My favorite little sort of pinwheel, Pranavidasana. Just like a little, tiny little dot, little pin. Slowly rolling out. Take a few breaths. Soles of the feet together, like a little upside down cobbler, just around. You might want to bring your nose in, feel good. Didn't do a whole lot of hippie stuff today, but take a moment here. Only so much you can do in sort of 40 minutes, but just to kind of show you a few ways. We'll do a part two of this where we do some kind of up your game hip openers, which are always fun. Take a few breaths here. Some nice twist. And you can up this one as well when you can clasp, grab your foot and just kind of stretch it out. It's nice. It's always how this one feels a bit better when there's someone there to kind of pull that one foot back. It's nice when teachers adjust this, but you know, you can find a nice stretch here yourself. If you have a buddy, maybe someone will come and be kind and give you a nice little adjustment, pinning your shoulders a bit down and giving a little help in that twist. Bringing it around, move this out of the back of my head. Other way, just a nice little sort of flowing to the other side. Lazy twist towards the end. And just again, maybe grabbing the legs, straightening it out if you want to really keep it bent. It's nice. You have to, if you do that, you want to kind of adjust the bottom leg to bring it a little more out and straight, like underneath you. Just that will increase the sort of sense of stretching out the side. I like this one, it's really nice. Come back into center space. Oh, I give it one more little squeeze, maybe a little happy baby, maybe a little something, knees in. And then let's just go ahead and do nothing. So relax yourself. You know, relax onto your mat or the floor, wherever you are. Take a nice exhale breath. Bring your palms to prayer once more, just on the crown, sort of the, your third eye. Take a few deep breaths here. And sometimes upping our game actually means dialing things down. So, you know, just kind of let yourself completely relax here. Let your heartbeat come back to normal or slow it down. And just having a nice sense of feeling quite whole and complete, even through the challenge, you know, whether you got some of that, all of that, none of that, you know, at least you know what exists. At least you know that, you know, there's still plenty of things to kind of work towards in terms of these little poses, these asanas that actually just, you know, they teach us things about ourselves. It's not just a physical thing where, okay, you know, if you get into it, yay, you know, you're master yogi, not really. It's just a nice way that if you're continually doing, you know, your standing stuff and you feel like, okay, I got this mastered, it's nice to know that there are ways to continue on growing as a student, if you're teaching, as a teacher, and just to continue this sort of ever lifelong journey that is yoga. Let your hands come by your sides. Stream of gratitude for our health, our well-being, our mobility, our flexibility, dexterity, strength. Not taking that for granted ever. Just our ability, our lungs, just to take such big breaths. Much gratitude. You can stay here, obviously, as long as you want. For the sake of the sequence, I'll just start to close it out. Moving from corpse into fetal pose, so we don't end with the death. Of course, we end with new life, so we don't end with corpse pose. It's not the last pose. This is the final pose. The corpse pose is more the penultimate pose. It's one that kind of preps us for the last pose, which is this rolling in like a fetus, ready to be reborn. New beginnings, new life, new possibilities that await. So it's like when we come to the mat, it's a sense of being reborn. Just acknowledging that cycle of life, death, rebirth.
You know, it doesn't end, nothing ends, it's just cycles. Beginnings and endings, and then another beginning. Nice big breath in, come up to sitting. Nice exhale. Let's take that opening mudra, the Tarabodhi mudra, bring it in. Connecting to that sort of higher, enlightened self, but it is the self, it's your self, right? It's a version of you, it's not outside of you, it's you. And it's always calling towards us, right? That little version that's always calling to us. Big breath in.
Namaste.
Thank you so much for joining me, Mercedes, in my kind of challenging little flow, the update game flow. I hope you enjoyed that, got some inspiration, got some ideas. Again, don't worry if that was, some of it was a bit tricky. Just kind of practice, have some fun, maybe practice that a few times. And if you're teaching, maybe it's fun to take some of that, extract a few things. If you're teaching maybe a level 2-3 class, where you can go, kind of when people get complacent, they go, oh, this is kind of old hat. Nice to kind of say, well, you can try this, and kind of let people up their game and just kind of keep them enthralled and loved and have the passion, the flame burning for this wonderful discipline and art and science and, you know, music that is yoga. So thanks so much for joining me, and hopefully I'll see you again on one of my other videos. I'll see you soon. Take care. Bye-bye. And email me if you need to, Mercedes@yourtongue.com, if you want to have any questions answered about this stuff. Okay, thanks so much.